it seems like everything's on the up and up with God. You're heading to heaven. We're marching to Zion. When the roll's called up yonder, I'll be there. That whole idea that I'm going all the way with Christ. And then go ahead and click. Everything gets up and down. Your spiritual life kind of goes zigzag. On one Sunday, you're doing wonderful things with God. Next Sunday, you kind of want to hide in the back room because your spiritual life has been, you haven't prayed all week. You're not fasting. You don't obey God when he tells you to do something. It's kind of the whole Jonah and Nineveh story. Have you ever seen the cartoon VeggieTale version of that? Jonah has been giving messages from the Lord all the time, proudly. And all of a sudden, he gets a message from the Lord he doesn't want to give. Go to Nineveh. And suddenly, when everybody in community says, all right, hey, Jonah, what's the message from the Lord today? He said, no, there is no message. I haven't heard anything from the Lord. He doesn't know what to do with the message. He's gone. So Christianity goes up and down like that because the road gets hard. Jesus never said it would be easy. And that's when we come to point number two, sanctification. I've heard a lot of salvation testimonies in my life from a person who's asked Jesus into their heart. But in Ezekiel 36, it talks about how God will take, he'll wash you with clean water, that's salvation. And then he said, I will take out of you the heart of stone and give you a new heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit in you and cause you to want to follow my laws and carefully keep my decrees. What he's talking about is heart transformation. It's not just where you let Jesus into your life and into your heart, but it's where you allow him to change your heart completely from the inside out. And that transformation, that surrender to God, allows you to go all the way with him. Go ahead and click the next slide. We get this picture in the Bible regularly, in the Old Testament. This journey here, this was supposed to be a short journey. Now, the Hebrews were slaves in Egypt until Moses came to set them free with the 10 plagues. This was supposed to be a short journey across the wilderness. They still had to cross the wilderness to the promised land. It was supposed to be a short journey for them to go. They even take the short journey, and then they vote God out when they get to the promised land and say, we don't want to go in there. And the next day, God says, fine, try going in alone. And then they all, I'm sorry, God. And he said, no, you're going to wander. Go ahead to the next slide. So up and down, back and forth in the desert, I've heard testimonies of people being in the desert their whole spiritual lives. They've been in the church since they got saved, 4 and 5 years old. But for the next 40 and 50 and sometimes 60 years, they sat in the church and didn't feel anything at all. And that's because they wandered in that wilderness. They voted to not go in to the promised land with God.
Right.
And they spend a long stretch of their lives in the desert where they shouldn't have been.
Right.
Go ahead. What has to happen is a new heart.
Yeah.
It's fine to be set free from sin and be made saved. It's fine to be here. This is God's plan for your life. Jesus died to set you free, but he also died to make you whole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So this happens first, and for a short period, we go through the wilderness, this part here, but we are supposed to go into the promised land.
Amen.
It's not that Israel was just set free and left in the desert. It's called Midian. It literally means the middle of nowhere. They weren't just set free to live in the desert at Mount Sinai. That wasn't their homeland. God said, you're going to go take the promised land. So they had to cross the Jordan into the promised land. And that's the second thing that has to happen in every Christian's life.
Amen.
Doesn't matter how old you are, how young you are, if you are a saved person, you need to be a sanctified holy person.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
It is in Scripture over and over and over again. It is God's will that you be sanctified holy. And that is the chart, and then the journey from there is upward and onward through the promised land with God. Was the promised land easy? No. It was conquest after conquest. They literally call it the band. They had to kick all of the evil out of the land. You had to renew the mind and renew the whole land. It is not easy, but it is a walk with God.
Yes.
Okay? Go ahead. The Christian Christian calendar aligns with this. We just had Easter. Jesus died and set us free. He saved us, okay? What happens is he shows himself to 500 of his disciples, his apostles, right? He ascends to heaven, Ascension Sunday. Then they're in the upper room for 10 days in prayer. Remember 110 of them in the upper room for 10 days in prayer? What happens on the 50th day? Pentecost Sunday. The Holy Spirit falls on them. The church begins. 3,000 people are added to their number in one day. It proves to us the cross is not the only event that Christian needs. You need a filling of the Holy Spirit. What is coming? We are in the Pentecost season. Easter is done. Okay? It was a couple Sundays in Wesley. Ascension Sunday is done now. We are, it's coming up. And we're heading into the season of Pentecost, and it's in June, the first week of June is Pentecost Sunday. And this is the most important day in the church, period. That's the birthday of the church. And we don't celebrate it anymore. Hardly at all. If I live to see the millennium, the thousand-year reign of Jesus, I want to be the conductor of the parade that walks down the main streets of every town on Pentecost Sunday with the big balloons and everything else for John Wesley and Finney and the holiness people. And we just worship the Lord all day in celebration on Pentecost Sunday because we want to remember that God gave himself to us that day. Yes, Jesus died on the cross. It's a very important day. By his blood we are saved and made holy. It's a very important day. But it's not the only important day. You say, Pastor, the New Testament is the only important part of the Bible. No, there's two testaments for a reason. God has a plan. There's two points that every Christian life needs.
Right.
If you do not understand this, see one of our leaders about it. You can ask us. But we are heading into Pentecost Sunday, and I want us to be a people of prayer. I want us to be a people, you know, ready for this, so that we can celebrate the first Sunday of June and just say, thank you, God, for giving us your Holy Spirit,
amen,
making the people holy that have not known otherwise.
Amen.
All right, let's pray. Gracious Heavenly